Hi and welcome back. So before we start, I want to give a massive shout out to my friend Camoflex. He is in camouflage and he's a flex guy. That's why he calls himself Camoflex. He's always bugging me of when I'm going to give him a shout out in one of my videos. So buddy, here it is, a shout out to Camoflex. Okay, so I made a message on YouTube a couple of days ago that I just ordered my biggest package with PlayStation 4 games ever. Part of it, this box here, has come in the mail today. And you may think, why are you at home and not at work? Well, 2 weeks ago, I got an accident. I tripped and fell and my foot weren't like, so that kind of hurts. Hopefully this is going to be the last week I'll be at home and I can start working again. I also, as you can see, got Monster Boy, the collector's edition for the PlayStation 4. I got the game on the Nintendo Switch, but I sold it because they announced this version. And you may think, hey Claude, why did you actually buy so many games? And that's actually, just as I said, in September, August and September, I have looked at my Nintendo Switch and PlayStation 4 limited run games collection. And I basically found out that, you know, a lot of games I just bought basically because just I bought everything. And especially on PS4, when limited run games just started, I bought everything that they announced. Games that I was not interested in, like Saturday Morning RPG, Octodad, Ape Odyssey, the first Ape that they released. I mean, they're fine, but I probably will never play them. And I figured to myself, you know what, why not just sell it? And at the end of September, well, the middle of September probably, not really the end, more like the middle of September, someone messaged me on the marketplace where I was selling all my games, and he said, I want to have them all. And I'm like, are you sure? That's like $900. He's like, yeah, I want to have all your games. And I was like, yeah, sure, send over the money and I'll send over the games. And he actually did. So I sent over the games and I figured to myself, you know, now I got a pretty nice budget. I'm gonna treat myself with new games. And I also ordered this from PlayAsia a couple of weeks ago. And as you've already seen, Monster Boy. So let's start with PlayAsia. And I'm pretty excited for this because I know what's in the box, of course. I mean, that would be really weird. I also really like how they wrap the box. Really sturdy. This is what limited run games should do. There are three games in here. Kabam. Hopefully you guys can see it. Oops, there are some stickers. Oh yeah, stickers from PlayAsia and their mascot and Fall of Light. So a couple of the collector's editions from PlayAsia and released by East Asia Soft were in clearance or in sale. They were $12. So I always wanted to have Fall of Light. From my knowledge, this is a sort of a Dark Souls-ish game, but hope it's true. Then we have another game that I was very excited for, but I just thought it was, and it was more expensive, and I was like, I just have other stuff to play and to buy, and that is X-Morph Defense. Hope you can see it. And this is also $12. 12 euros, that's it. For collector's editions, I mean, Limited Run, in my opinion, cannot compete against this. Now, the game that I wanted the most is a game that I actually saw at someone else's YouTube channel, and he only looks at indie games, and he was playing a game called Ultra Age, and it kind of looked like a Devil May Cry battle system, but it's sort of an RPG from my knowledge, and it's a Korean game, or it's a Chinese game, I think it's Korean, but the Japanese version, the physical version, supports English. So I'm like, hell yeah. I have no idea if you can actually see the box. Oh, you can see it probably. Because he is destroying sort of a robot. This kind of reminds me a little bit of Project Eve or Project Eden. you know, that upcoming game that they announced at the Sony conference with the lady. That was pretty cool. So, a part of the big box that I ordered has arrived, and I got all these games pretty cheap. At least I think it's pretty cheap. First up is the big one, and holy damn, this is much bigger than I anticipated. It is the La Malulana 1 and 2, the Hidden Treasure Edition. Look how freaking massive this edition is. And I got this for $20. I mean, that's pretty cool. At least I thought it was cool. I finally got the R-Type Final 2 because this game is getting pretty rare to find. So this was the most expensive one. It was $38. And I was like, whatever. A friend of mine has it. It looks so cool. I love shmups. So I had to get this. I got Golden Force. Really cool. I got the Hotline Miami Collection. Cost me $26. Really, really cool. I played my Hotline Miami 1 quite a lot. The Surge 2 got this pretty cheap. I liked the first one. Never beat it because it's extremely hard, but I did like the first one. Chaos Bane, Warhammer Chaos Bane. This is like a Diablo-style game in the world of Warhammer Fantasy. And I cannot wait to play this. I've been looking out for this game for quite a while. It was $20 and I'm like, I'm just gonna get it. I finally got Earth Defense Force 5. Already have the digital version. I'm massive fan of the Earth Defense Force games. And for $25, I could not say no. Another indie game that I saw at someone else their indie page, or actually it's the same guy because he only does indie. I think he's got like Indie World, something like that. He's really cool. However, Morbid looks super cool, but I kind of waited to get this game, and then I saw that it was sold out everywhere, and on the game store that I bought all these games, they had this for $25. I'm like, I want to have this. I really want to have this. This is sort of like a Metroidvania-ish game. Not sure if you can call it Metroidvania. A roguelike pixel art game. It looks beautiful. They say that's really cool. Last but definitely not least, the cheapest one. This cup. So this I bought for $6. Holy damn. It's Romance of the Three Kingdoms. I have Nobunaga's Ambition, the first one. This is, I think, the first Romance of the Three Kingdoms on PS4, at least, because you have sort of upgraded versions after this, kind of what they do with Dynasty Warriors, even though you don't really see much Dynasty Warriors anymore. I know there's Samurai Warriors 5, and I know there's going to be Dynasty Warriors 8 Empire or 7. I think it's 8. 8 or 9 Empire that's going to come out. And I probably will get it on PS5 instead of PS4, not sure. So these are all the games that I sort of got. It's kind of weird because this is like the biggest package I've ever bought, even though it's not that massive. I did buy two others, another shmup and a visual novel that was really cheap and it looked really cool, but these are pre-orders. They are going to come out in November, so we shall see. Hope you enjoyed this video. Like, share, comment, and subscribe. And like always, you're gonna see me next time.